America's favorite pastime. Doc Ellis didn't think he was pitching that day back in 1970, when he and his wife took a trip to the ballpark a little bit differently. So by the time that he hit the bullpen, half the world had melted away. Now that's about the time Coach Murtaugh came and said, "Doc, you'll pitch today." But taking the mound, the ground turned into the eyes of known birthday cake. That leadoff man came up and turned into a dancing rattlesnake. That crowd tracked back and forth in waves of color underneath the sun. That ball turned into a silver bullet, his arm into a gun. I took a look all around the world one time. I finally discovered you can't judge a book. Up three, down for three straight innings in a 0-0 tie. As all them batters' names come ringing from a voice out of the sky. Hallucinating Halloween saints, each new swing of the bat. His sinker looked like it was falling off a table, but nobody was hallucinating that. Took a look all around the world one time. I finally discovered can't judge a book. By the top of the seventh, he was up 1-0, giving them Padres fits. By the bottom of the eighth, he was up 2-0, and they still hadn't got any hits. With one out left to go in the game, batter looked like a baby child. That birthday cake was shaking, them waves of color was going wild. Time that he mowed the last man down, he was high as he'd ever been. Laughing to the sound of the world going round, completely unaware of the wind. And while the papers would say he was scattered that day, he was pretty as a pitcher could be. The day Doc Ellis of the Pittsburgh Pirates threw a no-hitter on LSD. I took a look all around the world one time. I finally discovered you can't judge a book.